In this video, we will cover what we at Moovweb call DevTools, a tool designed to help developers and engineers take advantage of all the benefits of using XDN. This widget can be enabled on any project that you're working on and helps you understand how the XDN edge caching and prefetching are working on your site. You can use this to understand the flow of responses from serverless to the edge and finally to the browser. To enable DevTools, first we'll need to install it. Instructions on how to install DevTools can be found on our documentation at developer.moveweb.com/guides/devtools, but I'll go over it briefly here. Before you install DevTools, you'll first need to make sure that the node packages xdn/devtools and xdn/prefetch are installed in your project. You can use regular install commands with npm or yarn to install these packages. To install DevTools, add the following to your client JavaScript bundle. Alternatively, you can add this script tag to your app's HTML. By default, DevTools will be enabled on anything served from the localhost, or any domain ending in moveweb-edge.io. Your project will automatically be given a moveweb-edge.io domain when you first push to the cloud. If you want to toggle DevTools on or off for a specific session, you can simply go to the path xdn/devtools/enabled or xdn/devtools/disabled on your project or local domain. This is also configurable as an environment variable. You should set this variable as true or false depending on if you need DevTools to be enabled or disabled. As a quick note, please remember not to enable DevTools on your production site. To get the full benefit of DevTools, you should enable prefetching on your site. Prefetching essentially allows your site pages to be prefetched to a user's device before the user initiates the navigation, which results in near instantaneous page loads. And this doesn't add any load in your backend system because a page is only prefetched if it's already cached on the XDN edge. So you can imagine as more and more users are visiting your pages, more and more pages are getting cached on XDN edge, which means more and more pages get prefetched and are loaded instantly. To enable prefetching, check out our guide on how to configure prefetching. Now, back to DevTools. Let's take a quick look at DevTools at work. Here I'm using a sample React store for an app, which is a React-based e-commerce template. You can find the link for it in the description. If you want to test multiple sessions, we recommend using incognito mode so you can simulate a fresh experience. And again, if you want to enable DevTools just for one session, even if you have DevTools disabled for your site, you can use this URL, demo.reactstorefront.io/xdn/devtools/enable. When you first open DevTools, you'll be met with a prompt to reload the page. After hitting reload and clicking start, you'll be met with this interface. This interface catalogs all the requests that were made when loading this page. Requests in green, seen here, are served from the browser cache and typically are the fastest requests. Requests in yellow and gray, which we'll cover later, are served from the XDN edge cache. Requests in red are served from your serverless backend. As you can see, DevTools provides stats on the number of requests of each type, the average time to first byte, and relative percentage of each type. Below these stats are options to clear your stats, clear your browser cache, and disable DevTools. At the bottom here, you can also see the Core Web Vitals, your LCP time, and CLS. Now this first request you see here did not hit the browser cache or the XDN edge, but went directly to the serverless backend. That's because this request is setting up the user session. It's best practice for user-specific sessions to not be cached, so that's why you see that this is going directly to the backend. You should now see a set of gray requests with a prefetch label. These requests have been prefetched and stored in the browser cache. They are gray, indicating that the user did not make the request. XDN made the request in the background as a prefetched request. You can see some of these requests indicate a prefetch miss. This is because a user has not visited these pages since the cache was last refreshed, and as such, the page was not saved in the XDN edge cache, therefore could not be successfully prefetched. Remember that XDN only prefetches URLs that are saved in the edge cache, so as not to overwhelm the backend servers. Now let's click on one of these links that gave us a prefetch miss tag. Once you click on this link, XDN will register the request and save the page in the XDN cache. Now if a second user were to go to the same page represented here in this separate session, you can see that the request for the page is now being served from the edge cache and can be successfully prefetched. So in summary, any page a user clicks on will be saved in the edge cache. When new users start navigating the site, these pages will be prefetched from the edge cache in the background and saved to the browser cache as the user browses the site. This is one of the ways XDN provides users with an instant site experience. Once you are done using DevTools, you can click Disable DevTools here to close it out. In summary, DevTools provides an easy-to-use interface where you can see where pages are being cached and helps you narrow down which pages and requests are not being prefetched, so you can figure out what steps to take to help improve your site performance. If you want to learn more about how to use DevTools as a part of your debugging process, check out our documentation. The link is in the description. Thanks for listening, and happy coding.